I spent a few seasons in Australia back in the day, so when Slingshot asked me to do a road trip there, I was stoked.
Welcome to van life.
It's a fucking pigsty. Cavemen survive.
If you're feeling low, then give it a go.
You know when you're doing a song about a smoke.
Meet Katie the camper van. We lived in Katie for 2 weeks. First up, Perth Cable Park.
Time moves a little slower here. The paint fills cause the summer's here exclusive air. And we're new and then know what you would know of. Locals here bright, they show up just to show off. I'm in, take a load off, just to watch the day go by. Philosophizing with the friends like they play tough. They prophesize on the bench by the main road, right? They got a fight, some like Aya with you say so. Guys, but what a banger. Fox News got them lit. They're shook, cause fundamentalists, the new communists. A girl with a shamanist, clutch a handbag purse. I'm like, damn man, then it's all back has jokes. Cause I'm a gentleman, but then again, most of us are. First name basis in the bank, the post office, the bar, the grocery, the parts. A lady, I ain't trying to grab your pension. The old men on the bench.
Direct from the transistor radio in your lounge room.
We had a sick day at Perth Cable Park. I was really impressed, but I could not wait to get back to one of my favourite kite spots in the world, Woody's.
We're living in the days when everybody's saying what a time to be alive, but I'm feeling out of place like I'm living out of space, cause it seems I'm stuck in time. It's like we rhyme to life,
right in the shadow of the cold
war, and that's so quiet night.
Like Marshall took a whole job to fight. Time moves a little slower here. Day feels like a week, it feels like it could go a year. And we know we're near nothing, man, it's so true. I don't tell them where I'm from, I tell them where I'm close to. And I could go through an atlas and show you on a map, but you still look at me sideways and treat me like I'm backwards. But that's just fine, it so happens. So I'm happy living in a city that is trapped in time. While you're lined up in traffic, I'm not. Panic by transit, I'm back in time for a TV dinner around an early night. Cause we get dressed to travel, got an early flight. Been doing laps of the earth, we're doing laps of the sun. Trying to put where I'm at on a map, cause where I'm from we never get a mention, but old at and then some. Once again the old men on the bench.
And across the country they came in waves, thousands upon thousands of.
We had loads of Slingshot and ride engine demos. And in Geraldton, Kate even made it onto the beach.
Well, let's go, let's go.
We're living in the days when everybody's saying what a time to be alive, but I'm feeling out of place like I'm living out of space, cause it seems I'm stuck in time. It's like we rise to life,
right in the shadow of the cold war.
And that's so quiet night.
Like Marshall.
We ventured 15 hours north of Perth to a remote place called Nalu, somewhere I've always wanted to go to, as it's meant to be one of Australia's best left-hand point roads. The swell was relatively small for this place, but it was still amazing. We sessioned all day, only stopping to eat. I feel most comfortable in bindings when I've got a kite in my hand, and I still see the waves very much as ramps, not waves, so I get some funny looks when I'm out in bindings, but it doesn't stop me having a bloody good time.
Wardell refrigerators, the cooler choice. The dieting revolution, taking the world by storm.
Well, Montaigne, let's
go. We're living in the days when everybody's saying what a time to be alive, but I'm really out of place like I'm living out of space, cause the things I'm stuck in time, it's like we're right through life.
Right, in the shadow of the cold war. Took a whole job, 55.
Sad encounter with a shark today.
Paddleboarding back to the beach after an epic session when I felt a bump at the back of my board. I turn around and saw this huge tiger shark as I fell in. When I hit the water, I got dragged for a few seconds before the leash snapped. Oh my god, I thought I was dead. I got onto the board as quick as I can and realised the shark had already gone. Look at what the shark's teeth did to the leash. That could have been my leg. I don't think the shark was attacking me, I think it was just curious, but didn't half scare me. Luckily, I lived to tell the story, and what an insane trip this was turning out to be. Make sure you tune in for part 2 when I compete in the Rock Nest to Perth race. Cheers, Perth.
Fucking export, mate. The emu export. It's all you drink in fucking WA.